In this video, we will use boxplots to compare two distributions. Let's suppose that we want to compare two online math tutoring services, Acme Tutoring and Best Tutoring. For simplicity, let's just call them A and B. Now let's suppose that 23 students post the same math question to each tutoring service and record the wait time. These dot plots show the fictional wait time distributions for the two hypothetical tutoring programs. I'm now going to summarize the data using boxplots. The boxplot divides the data into four equal-sized groups called quartiles. In other words, there's the same amount of data in each quartile. I'm now going to color code the quartiles so that we can see the data in each quartile more clearly. The white and gray regions alternate quartiles. So we can see that whichever quartile we pick has five data points within it. So for instance here on distribution B, the first quartile has five data points. Similarly, if I look at distribution B and I look at the fourth quartile, I see that there are also five data points within that quartile. Similarly for distribution A. What can I tell about the distribution of wait times just by looking at the box plot? Well, first I can see that the two distributions have some similarities. The median is the mark inside of the box, and I can see that they have the same median wait time, which is at 15. Just mark that with the vertical line so we can see it. There we go. Now the tails of these box plots mark the minimum and maximum values. And let's use some reference lines so that we can see those also. So the minimum values are the same in each distribution. They're at 1 minute. The maximum values are also the same at 50 minutes. Now this means that both distributions have an overall range of 49 minutes. Overall range measures from the minimum to the maximum value, so this would be 49. I can also see that both distributions have the same shape. They're skewed to the right because the upper half of the data is more spread out than the lower half. So the upper half of the data from the second quartile to the maximum is more spread out than the distance from the second quartile to the minimum. Similarly, in distribution A, we have a much larger spread in the upper half of the data compared to the lower half. Now, how do the distributions differ? Well, I can see when I look at the box part of the box plot that the boxes start and end at different points. The box connects the first quartile and the third quartile, and it marks the middle half of the data. This makes sense because the box contains the middle two quartiles, and each quartile contains about 25% of the data. Now we can use the endpoints of the box to describe typical values for any distribution. In other words, the interval starting at the first quartile and ending at the third quartile is a good way to represent typical values in a distribution. So for example, typical wait times for tutoring program A are 7 to 37 minutes from the first quartile to the third quartile mark, compared to only 10 to 20 minutes for tutoring program B. So to summarize, I can see that both tutoring services have the same median wait time of 15 minutes. However, program A has more variability in wait times around the median. Typical students, the middle 50%, wait between 7 and 37 minutes for program A, but only 10 to 20 minutes for program B. Now I'd like to talk about the variability around the median a little bit more and how to measure it. The length of the box in a box plot is the distance between the first and third quartile, and this is a way to measure the spread of the middle half of the data. We call this the interquartile range, or IQR for short. To find the IQR, we just compute Q3, the third quartile, minus Q1, the first quartile. For A, the IQR is 30 minutes. 37 minus 7. The IQR for B is 10 minutes, 20 minus 10. To summarize, both tutoring services have the same overall range of 49 minutes, with the shortest wait time at 1 minute and the longest wait time at 50 minutes. But in other ways, Program A has less consistent wait times. We can see this when we compare the interquartile ranges, which we call the IQRs. When we look at a typical wait time as defined by the middle half of the data, Program A has a 30-minute difference compared to only a 10-minute difference for Program B.